Good afternoon. Hope everyone enjoyed their meal. It was wonderful. Thank you, cafeteria ladies. I'd like to welcome you to our Veterans Day program today. What an awesome day it is to observe this. But I would ask that if you have served in any branch of the military, if you will please stand at this time. Thank you. I would like to say thank you for your service, for your time to our country. And I also would like to say to the families of these people that have served our country, thank you for allowing us to borrow your husbands and wives to help fight for our freedom and for the opportunity to get to know them. We have a lot of freedoms in this country because of them fighting for us. I would like to start the program today, if I can, with a prayer. So if you would, please stand and pray with me. Father God, we want to thank you for this day and for the many blessings that you bestow upon us, not only as individuals, but as families and community members. We want to thank you for every veteran here that has served, all of the current enlistees that are serving now. Lord, I want to ask a special blessing on everyone who defends our country and fights for our freedom so that we can have the freedom to do what we're doing right now. I pray a special blessing on their families as well, Lord, that you will keep them safe while they're away. Let them enjoy their time together as a family when they're together. But Father, I just want to especially thank you now for our country and for the freedoms that we have in this country because of these young men and women. I want to pray for our country right now as we go into a new era of leadership. I pray, Lord, that you will allow our decision makers in Washington to do what's best for our country. And I pray that as our enlisted men and women still fight for our freedom, that you will protect them, whether it's abroad or here. Lord, forgive us where we fail you. And as always, thank you for sending your son to die on the cross for our sins. For it's in Christ's name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Now the two young ladies who will be leading us in the Pledge of Allegiance, two freshmen, Lindsay Sanders and Brandy Alvarado, as they come forward.
Please remain standing for the American flag. Attention, salute, pledge.
Thank you.
may be seated. Bam! Color guard, post the colors, post the colors. Bam, horns up, horns up.
Elk pride.
One, two, three.
And now to read the preamble to the Constitution, Senior Brittany Jones.
We the people of the United States, in order to form a more perfect union, establish justice, ensure domestic tranquility, provide for the common defense, promote the general welfare, and secure the blessings of liberty to ourselves and our posterity, to ordain and establish this Constitution for the United States of America.